Now, today, guys, the NEO stock gave us or just announced their Q3 earnings results, and I must say some of the people were very happy, some were not, some were kind of like in the middle. So me, I fall on the kind of people that are very happy about the earnings results, irrespective of NEO reporting a wider than expected loss. Because me personally, I think I understand why sort of like NEO reported such a wider than expected loss. And one of the reason being the fact that you will remember that NIO will be releasing three models in 2022 that will be having their latest version of the NT 2.0, which is something that is incredible. And it's something that you should have at the back of your mind. Guys, it takes money to make money. So I think the reason why NIO sort of like encountered some huge expenses this quarter is simply because of the preparation of the upcoming three models that they start planning to deliver next year in 2022. So that's why I say that I understand as to why they reported this wider than expected loss. But the good thing is that as for the revenue, they managed to beat the revenue as per the analyst expected, which is something that is incredible and has to show you that NIO, it's in the right direction, or it's going in the right direction as it is growing, or we are seeing growth even every quarter they report or release their earnings results, which is something that is making me to say that I was very happy when I saw these earnings results, irregardless of NIO not meeting the analyst expectation EPS. Otherwise, without going any further, please know that I'm not a professional financial advisor. This video is just for entertainment purposes, and if you seek professional financial advice, you already know what to do by now, and that is you need to go and consult the professionals. Otherwise, if you like the content that I'll be sharing or giving you about the NIO stock in relation to the earnings results and the other latest developments we read today, please don't forget to hit that likes button, comment, and subscribe. And once you subscribe, if you're new, please don't forget to hit or press the notification bell so that you don't miss the good content and the latest developments that we share on this channel regarding the stocks that we follow, like NIO and the others. So please do watch this video until the end, because I definitely think that you are going to definitely agree with me when I say that NIO did deliver some good Q3 earnings results, irregardless or irrespective of them reporting a wider than expected loss. Now, without a waste of time, you will remember by now that for the past, I think, month or so, I've been telling you that give NIO until 2022, at least decide after 2022, probably around this same time. And if you're not happy with the NIO stock, maybe you can sell it. I will understand. And the reason why I've always been telling you that give NIO and see or wait for NIO until 2022 is finished is because there's so much that NIO is expected to achieve in next year in 2022, which is why I certainly believe that around this time next year, I think you will be very certain of holding this NIO stock for a longer term, because the things or the milestones that it plans to achieve will definitely amaze you. And most of those targets I've already shared with you in many of my previous videos, telling you what we ought to expect in the year 2022. So 2022, I believe it's one of those years that will be a turnaround for the NIO stock, because there's just so much happening there, which is why I was telling you even at the beginning of this video to say that part of the reason why NIO reported some wider losses than what analysts expected is simply because of the in preparation of the upcoming models that they will be selling or delivering next year in 2022. Because you'll remember that NIO plans to deliver three new models next year in 2022, including the ET7, which is something that is incredible. And those are believe are some of the expenses that made NIO to sort of like head or report high expenses when comparing to the expenses they had reported in the Q2 of 2021. Otherwise, without a waste of time, let us quickly go have a glimpse on these earnings or on the Q3 earnings results that we were waiting for. Now, NIO for the Q3 of 2021, they reported a total revenue of around $1.52 billion, which is yet another total revenue generated in a single quarter. This is on itself is something that is truly amazing and has to show you that this company continues to grow in terms of delivering or in terms of sales on their cars, which is something that, number one, it's something that you should take note of. Number two is that this 1.52 billion US dollars total revenue that NIO generated for this Q3 of 2021 managed to beat the total revenue that analysts expected, because you will notice that I seen on the screen, analysts expected NIO to deliver or to report a total revenue of less than 1.5 billion US dollars, which is something that to see that they manage total revenue that analysts expected is something that you should take note, and you should, I think, always have at the back of your mind before you decide to sell this stock, because this just simply mean that NIO, in terms of revenue generation, they continue to report better revenues quarter after quarter, which is something that has to probably assure you that even in the next quarters, we can expect NIO to continue reporting higher revenue figures, which is something that is incredible. Otherwise, going to the EPS or the earnings per share, NIO for the Q3 of 2021, they reported an EPS or an earnings per share of negative 0.36 yen, which is wider, or which is a much wider loss than what analysts expected, because analysts expected NIO to report a loss of around 0.3 yen. Now, to see them reporting 0.36 or negative 0.36 is something that, like I said, to some of the new investors, this is a concern. But me personally, I think that I understand as to why did NIO report this wider loss than what most analysts expected, because you will remember, guys, like I told you, part of NIO reporting such a wider loss is that you remember that on their Jake NIO factory, they are currently upgrading that. They finished the first phase, then they are now busy with the second phase at that Jake NIO factory, which is something that I believe it sort of like added to the loss of this. And you will remember that another thing that, guys, like I said, overall or in a nutshell, one of the things that is seriously making them to report a wider loss, or that made them have some higher expenses, is in preparation of the three models that they plan to deliver next year. So this is one of the things, or this is one of the main things that I believe it led to NIO reporting such a wider than expected loss. Because as seen on the screen, to prove what I'm saying is that you will see, notice that the research and development expenses went up to over 186 million US dollars, and this came from around 136 million US dollars from the Q2 of 2021. Now, you see some of the things that I'm telling you, the research and development expenses, as seen on the screen, they went up to 185 million US dollars, which is in relation, or the reason why this figure went higher, or this expense went higher, it's simply because of the preparation, like I'm telling you for many times now, of their upcoming three models that they plan to deliver next year. Otherwise, going to the cash balance, now NIO, as it stands, they have a total cash balance of around 7.3 billion dollars, which is something that is incredible, because this strengthens, or it continues to strengthen, their balance sheet. As you remember that a company with a good balance sheet, it's perceived to perform well. Now, this is one of the things that I believe so many companies and the big financial institutions are very comfortable investing in NIO, because they know that they have got a very strong cash balance sheet, which is something that is incredible, and has to be the one to make your heart to be at ease, because I mean, with a cash this high, it's something that I believe that, yeah, it sort of like offers you a safety bet on this company NIO, which is something that is incredible. Otherwise, another thing that attracted me when I look at those earnings is their gross margin. You remember that on gross margin, the higher the figure, the better, or the higher the percentage, the better. So NIO for the Q3 of 2021, they reported a gross margin of around 20.3%, which was higher than that gross margin which they report in the Q2 of 2020, because you remember that in the Q2 of 2020 they reported a gross margin of around 18.6%. Now, to see that now they are reporting a gross margin of around 20.3% is something that is incredible, and has to show you that this company continues to do good, or this company continues to do very well, which is something that I believe you should have at the back of your mind before you decide to want to sell this new stock, because this is a company that's doing very well, guys. I don't want to lie to you. This is a company that will do very well. So, like I said, NIO is one of those companies that you should give them some time. Hence, I always stress the point that give them until end of 2022 and then decide if you want to stay with this company. But I tell you, NIO is one of those companies that towards the end of 2022, so many people, I personally think that this company actually might tend to be profitable towards the end of 2022. I think 2022, either Q3 or Q4, probably Q4, they might report a positive EPS for the very first time because of the good things or because of the preparations they are busy with right now, which is something that is incredible and has to motivate you to stay long onto this NIO stock. Otherwise, NIO indicated that for the Q4 of 2021, they anticipate to deliver between 23,500 and 25,500 vehicles. So, which to some, also these figures are a bit of a concern to some, because some are expecting NIO to deliver over 27,000, some over 26,000. Which to me, I believe that NIO at the end of the year, they will, or in December, they will manage to deliver if they don't have any constraints of chip shortage and all those things. They can deliver over 12,000 vehicles, which I may believe, or which makes me want to believe that they can easily go over 26,000 vehicles for the Q4 of 2021. So for the Q4 of 2021, I think NIO will be able to deliver over 26,000 vehicles for the quarter. And the reason behind this, and I think I touched this in one of my previous videos to say that November and December, for the last remaining 2 months, we can expect NIO to deliver over 10,000 vehicles. And if you do your calculations based on that bracket or based on that target which NIO set for themselves, so you will notice that it just simply means that for November and December, NIO will be delivering over 10,000 cars, which is something that is incredible. So you remember that still in one of my previous videos, I did cover and said that I believe that NIO in November, they will deliver, or they can deliver, over 11,000 cars. And in December, I see, or I foresee NIO delivering over 12,000 cars. And the reason why my December figure is high is because things tend to look very good for this industry, as car sales tend to go higher because people in December, they want to buy cars, they want to go visit their families in brand new cars, which is why we see a big demand in that month. And this or that is the main reason why I'm anticipating or predicting that NIO, if it's not for the chip shortage and maybe the other things that can affect their deliveries, they can easily deliver over 12,000 vehicles for the month of December. Otherwise, guys, these earnings were good, like I said, or these Q3 earnings results, which NIO just announced today, I certainly believe that they were good earnings, and I am still very bullish on the NIO stock because it is said to do very well. Otherwise, before you decide to sell this NIO stock, or before you decide to reduce probably your holdings on the NIO stock, please go out there, do your own due diligence, and don't just sell or reduce your holdings on the NIO stock due to social media or due to some people saying that NIO is a bad stock, NIO is whatnot. Just decide, go do your own due diligence, and I think at least if you give NIO a chance, it will definitely prove itself to you that this is one of those companies that many people are going to regret not taking this opportunity, or not taking these current trading levels that NIO is currently trading at, and invest into this company, because a few years down the line, this is going to be the leader in this EV market. Otherwise, with all that, guys, I make tons and tons of stock market investing videos, and if you think that this video was amazing, please don't forget to hit that likes button, comment and subscribe, and once you subscribe, if you're new, don't forget to hit that notification bell so that YouTube can notify you every time I release a video. Otherwise, that's all from me, and I wish you nothing but the best in your stock market investing journey, and God bless you all.